pop. Can we talk about this later? Kind of in the middle of something here.
Yeah, hello?
Sure. You don't have time to talk to your father, who's come all the way out here to see you.
Aw, oh, Pop.
No. I mean, to me, it didn't look like you were doing so hot. Or what I know, huh? I'm just an old man with a potato on his chest, right?
Aw, oh, Pop, come on. Not now, in front of my...
Nemesis.
Yeah, she's my nemesis. Other than the fact that we fight each other, we get along pretty good.
Pretty well.
Right, pretty well.
I don't believe this. Getting along with a superhero... Come on, let's go.
But Pop...
I said let's go.
Fine.
The old 23 spun skidoo!
Out of fire! Oh, hey, listen. Sorry about my Pop. He could be a little...
Junior!
Yeah, all right, Pop! Sorry, again. See you later.
Good luck.
Yeah? Who's asking?
It's me! Baker!
Baker? Baker? No way! Oh, man, I haven't seen you since elementary school!
I think you mean elementary school. Same old butcher.
Oh, sorry, man. The parking lot was full, so I had to drive around for the... Butcher? Hey!
Baker, is that...
The candlestick maker!
Oh, man! The troublemaking trio, together again! What have you guys been up to?
Well, I grew up and opened a bakery.
And I make candles. My shop is next door to his.
Wow, you guys really branched out, huh?
So you need to get some money from the bank for your butcher shop, huh?
Oh, yeah, right. My butcher shop.
This is what you left your home and your family behind for?
Oh, Pop, come on.
Forget it. I didn't come here to bother you. I came because, well, I guess I always dreamed that when you got older, you and I would rob stuff together. Be a real criminal duo. I even had a name picked out for us. Are you ready? Meat and Potatoes. Notice I put your name first.
Oh, Pop, that's nice. I'm really touched.
I have to say, after seeing your performance today, it looks like I came in the nick of time. You really stink.
Yeah, not so touched anymore.
What do you say, son? Be the meat of my potatoes? Yes or no?
Well, it's not that easy, see?
Yes or no?
Quit badgering me!
Badgering?
Yeah, it means to pester and nag me. To ask me again and again to do something.
Where'd you learn that?
From Wordgirl.
That's it. It's worse than I thought. You need my help, son.
Yeah, Pop.
It's settled then. We're a team, father and son. Meat and potatoes.
Pop, I don't... All right, here goes. Chicken pot pie! I'm not feeling it.
No,
it's not working. I don't believe this. I've lost my ability to summon meat. All right, go ahead. You gonna arrest me now, Wordgirl?
Well, you haven't really done anything wrong, except for moping a bit. Is something bothering you?
I don't know. Stealing stuff, shooting meat, going to jail. Maybe it's just getting a little... routine.
Well, then it sounds like a perfect time for you to quit your life of crime and become a law-abiding citizen.
You're kidding, right? That kind of sounds boring, too.
Yeah, but I still have some preparations to take care of.
Well, it's gonna be hard to prepolate when you're covered in...
Hold it. I'm gonna stop you there.
What'd I do now?
The word is preparation, not prepolate. It means to get ready for something. Like I said, I have someplace to be, so could we just,
I'm sick of being wrong all the time.
Yeah, okay.
It's just, I love words, and I want to use them more rightly.
Oh, actually, it's not more rightly.
Like last week, I was robbing this bank, right? And I asked the guy behind the counter for everything he's got and make it click. He hands me a bag of these.
Castanets? What kind of bank has a bag of...
Don't even get me started. So I'm trying to tell the guy that I don't want these. I want the loot.
Loot, meaning money?
Right, but he can't understand me.
Understand.
Right, so the teller cuts me off and says he's not gonna help me if I keep bambling.
You mean rambling.
I think so. I don't know. I need help.
Actually...
No, he's not. He's with me now. Together, we're meat and potatoes. He's no longer some pushover you could just defeat and take to jail over and over and over.
Yeah, all right, Pop. We get the idea.
But not anymore, Missy.
All right, that's it. Pop, enough. I'm not gonna let you badger me into doing something I don't want to do.
Hey, you used the word badger. Nice.
Yeah, thanks, but I'm on a roll here.
Right, sorry.
Look, I'm not moving back with you, and I'm not joining you. Meat and potatoes is your dream, Pop, not mine.
Well, doesn't that just beat all? Where's the gratitude, I ask you? Where's the sense of family?
Look, that guilt trip's not gonna work anymore, Pop. You can't badger me, you hear?
Just in case it hasn't been defined yet, badger means
I defined it before!
Oh, you did? Okay. It means to pester someone.
You're the pest.
Hey, that's it. You're going down. Sorry, but you too, Butcher.
Oh, yeah? Well, not this time, you hear? I don't need to be badgered about this, and I don't need to join meat and potatoes, because I'm your greatest nemesis, you hear? I don't like it, but you didn't even taste it.
Oh, what, are you gonna cry now?
Hey, cut that out!
I think somebody can't take the heat. Am I right, folks?
Yeah. What's gonna happen?
I'm warning you!
Maybe you should get out
pastrami
of
it! Pastrami attack!
Pastrami?
Yeah, that's right, Chef. And neither of us is getting out of any kitchen until I make something you like. Even if it takes all day.
Bam
it,
yeah.
All right, okay.
Please be considerate of other readers.
But it's not me. It's sorry.
Oh, this book is totally whamming me, dude, yeah.
Shh. The library lady said we should be considerate.
What?
Considerate.
What?
Considerate. Sorry.
Hold on. Sorry to cut you off, Word Girl, but you're really starting to ramble.
What?
And I should probably get going.
Me? Ramble?
Yes.
I do not believe this.
Well, you were talking a lot and not really staying to one topic, right? Wasn't she?
Huggy.
I taught Word Girl a word.
Well, no, technically I already knew what ramble meant. I just didn't think it applied to me.
Be worth it when my pet here and I win that talent show and all those game tokens. My feet are dancing just thinking about it. Hey, everybody! You! Well, you're the only one here. I taught Word Girl a word! Oh, man. I can't wait to tell the teacher she fixed me.
Oh, sorry, dear, but Word Girl is correct. The word is correct, not correctify, and it's better than I, not better than me.
Oh, no. The effects of the class. They're wearing off. I'm all broken again. No. Pull it together. Hold it! Time out!
Time out?
Yeah, time out! I gotta check on... No! Little Mittens! Where'd she go?
Uh-oh.
Little Mittens! This isn't happening. This isn't happening!
It's okay. We'll find him.
I just want my Little Mittens back. He could be hurt. I have to find him!
Don't get so frantic.
I am not getting frantic!
Sound frantic to me.
Thanks. You're a big help. You know what? Hamalanche.
Hamalanche?
Little Mittens!
We can never be together.
Whoa. Why not? Because I have sweaty hands?
No, it's not that. It's because I'm a vegetarian.
What's a vegetarian again? I know we've covered this.
Yeah, multiple times. A vegetarian is a person who doesn't eat meat.
Oh, thanks, Word Girl.
No problem.
No!
Little later, and still no sign of that adorable little kitten, Lil Mittens.
Lil Mittens! Lil Mittens! Oh, it's you. What do you want?
We just saw you down here frantically looking for Lil Mittens. I thought we could help. Then we could finish battling and I could take you to jail.
I don't need your help. In fact, it's your fault that Lil Mittens is gone.
My fault? Maybe if you didn't try to lead him into a life of crime, Lil Mittens would still be around.
Hey, he came to me looking to join up, okay? He came to me!
But this isn't your pet. Shame on you, Butcher.
Hey, I found him. He was sitting on a bench with his hobo sack. Finders keepers, Word Girl. If you just let us get away, he wouldn't be lost right now. This is all your fault. Your fault!
Huggy, duck for cover! Is this your kitty cat?
Will Mittens, where have you been? Are you hurt? Hey, look at you! Where did you find him?
He was just down the street chasing a butterfly.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. You're a naughty little kitty. Yes, you are. You scared the ham out of me. Don't you run away like that again, okay? Oh, little mitten.
Wait, hold on. This is all I get?
Yeah, well, technically, today's a training day for you. You aren't supposed to be paid at all, but you did such a good job, you shouldn't leave empty-handed.
Hey, that's not fair!
Sorry, I'm the vending boss, and you're the vendor. Man, those are the rules.
No, I'm the butcher, and you're gonna give me all the money now!
Well, you've sunk to a new low, butcher. A famous villain like you stealing game tokens? That's like stealing from kids.
Yeah, I know, word girl. But I was so close to getting the high score on the dancing fool game, and then I ran out of money for tokens. Well, I'm not about to let that happen again.
You better put the tokens back, butcher, unless you want to start rehearsing the jailhouse jig.
Forget that, word girl. Salami slice!
Good work, Captain Huggy Face.
So I guess you're gonna arrest me now, huh?
Well, I'm in a bit of a hurry, so if you give all the tokens back, I'll let you go.
I guess that's reasonable under the circumstances.
I'm on my way to rehearse. I mean, to watch a...
I never thought of it like that. Of course, Wordgirl. You bring that pet back to the owner. I gotta go in the back now. I got something in my eye.
Plans of the troublemaking trio. And don't forget, if you're finicky about where you get your word-filled fun and excitement, tune in next time for another adventure of Wordgirl.